Hi friends, I am Shrenidhi Hande and this video is about Zoomcar. I run a travel and automobile blog called inidhi.net. I have been blogging since 2006, that's about 13 years now. I have also been renting cars on self-drive since 2008, way before Zoomcar came into existence. I've seen Zoomcar begin as a small company in Bengaluru and over time grow exponentially all over India, multiple cities and thousands of cars as they have today. I've seen their policies change, pricings change, new schemes come into play, and as a company and as a customer, what's the impact it's having on my renting cars from them. Of late, I'm seeing a lot of complaints online. Lot of customers complaining about excessive damage charges, cars breaking down, other kind of harassments or cheatings, and so on. So what does this mean? You should never book on Zoomcar? Every booking is a cheat? Is there a better alternative? Is there something we can do to minimize this impact of these inconveniences? In this video, as a long-term customer, based on my experience and observations, I'll try to give you a set of tips and tricks that you can use during your Zoomcar booking to minimize the possibility of things going wrong, to minimize the possibility of having to face a lot of inconveniences during your Zoomcar booking. So please understand, there's no foolproof way, there's no 100% guarantee that everything will go perfect. A small bit of risk that you will have to take if you're renting cars on self-drive. But otherwise, it is possible to reduce the impact to a reasonable extent if you are a little bit smart, little bit careful. Okay, so before we proceed, let us understand who are all the stakeholders in this game of renting cars on self-drive. First of all, it's you as a customer. You are making a payment, you are booking a car, you want nice car to be delivered to you on time, in clean condition, in very good running condition. You want to go on your trip, enjoy it and return the car and get on with your life. So that's what you would want as a customer. Now, there are other stakeholders as well. There are other customers who are booking the car behind you or before you. Zoomcar doesn't keep huge gap between two bookings. Maybe they'll keep 2 hours. So the customer who has rented the same car before you, if he or she doesn't return it on time, so they get delayed because of traffic, because of breakdown, or they just decided to extend the trip, now your booking gets affected. You won't get the car ready on time. So they are the other stakeholders. Now there are third stakeholders, the Zap subscribers. So these are people who have rented car on a monthly basis from Zoomcar. So they would have paid 15 to 40,000 depending on the car model. And when they are not using the car, they list it on the platform for people like you and me to book and use. So they are the third stakeholders. They have certain obligations, like they need to ensure the car is clean, it's easily accessible, it should have 30% fuel. Sometimes that doesn't happen or they don't check. So things can go wrong with them as well. So they are the third stakeholders. Often they park the car somewhere deep interiors in front of their house, difficult to access. So those are some challenges. I'll come to it a little later. The fourth stakeholder is Zoomcar. So now they're shifting more and more as a platform than a company with owning assets like cars. So they want to offload the risk of ownership probably, and they want to have more and more cars subscribed, or like the ownership partly shifted to the car owners of Zap subscribers, and Zoomcar will just act as a platform, taking a commission from the bookings that happen. Of course, they still own a lot of cars, they have their delivery centers, staff, but Zoomcar as a stakeholder, they need to maximize the revenue from each of the cars. They have to cut cost, they have to automate as much as possible, they have to keep other stakeholders like subscribers, employees, everybody happy. So they are the fourth stakeholders. So the renting a self-drive car is now a game between these four stakeholders, and there are a lot of things that can go wrong, right? Sometimes cars are not in good condition, sometimes they break down, sometimes they're not serviced on time, right? Sometimes some employees have unethical behaviors, they try to cheat, they try to make more money from the customer. So a lot of things will go wrong. Right? Particularly if you are planning a long trip, you have planned 5-6 days booking, you have to go cross country, right? Then if the car gets delayed, if the car is not good condition, your trip will be ruined, right? You will have very bad experience. So how do we tackle this? What precautions can we take to minimize the impact while renting a car from Zoomcar? I will give my tips from the perspective of a long-term renter, like 5 days, 6 days, 1 week, you want to go, right, to 500,000, 2,000 kilometers and come back. The same tips apply for short-term rental, whether it's 1 day, 2 day as well. But there, you have a better, like, you can probably rent a local car. The impact is a lot less when you're renting for short-term for within-city use, right? But you can use the same tips and tricks for short-term rental as well. So first of all, understand that there is no difference in process from a Zoomcar perspective, whether you're booking for 2 days or 2 weeks. It's the same process. Just because you're going on a long drive, they're not going to get the car serviced for you. It's not economical to do service the car between every two bookings. It will be serviced only if the car doesn't move or if it's a manufacturer recommended service intervals come in and they have to send it for service. Otherwise, don't expect a fully serviced car. They'll only do some basic cleaning and that's it, right? Now, if you are booking a car for a very long time, long-term rental, what all you can do? The first thing you can do is car type, okay? Select a newer model. If you select, say, a Scorpio or a Figo, it's highly possible that those cars are very old, 5 years, 6 years old, with a lot of kilometers on the odo, and probability of them failing is a bit higher. So you select a cars that are introduced little recently, right? You can select maybe Tata Hexa or Nexon or Hyundai Verna or this kind of cars which are introduced in past 2-3 years. They are very likely to be newer cars with in better condition. So that way you're eliminating the risk of getting a poor quality old car assigned to you. Again, this is not 100% guaranteed. They might still assign you a different car saying whatever you booked is not available, but most of the time you will get what you book, so this should work. Okay, the next one, right? If possible, avoid an extra long road trip with rented cars. For example, you're going from Bangalore to Goa. It might make more sense, okay, you go to Goa by flight or train or bus and then rent a Zoomcar locally than renting in Bangalore going 600,000 kilometers all the way to Goa. Of course, you can do it, but just that if you break down halfway, you're in a big trouble, your holiday is going to get ruined. So if you have an option, if the car is available at a closer city, book that. Right now they are available in hundreds of cities. It's not very difficult. So you might just find a car closer to your destination than having to drive hundreds of thousands of kilometers all the way. So this is second tip, which you can, you can reduce the risk of things going bad or getting stranded middle of the road. Third, try to book a car from a Zoomcar's garage or Zoomcar's location and not from a subscriber's location. What do I mean by this? Every city, Zoomcar has a set of garages or locations where they have parked dozens of their cars and they have some employees present there to take care of these cars. You go there and you can get a car and drive out. Versus the subscriber cars which are parked somewhere near their home, usually a residential area deep inside, far from main road. Right. So why I'm saying don't book a subscriber car and book a Zoomcar garage, because usually the subscriber location there will only be one car. If that breaks down, if that is not available, you are going to get delayed heavily. Right. If they have to provide alternate car, you have to go to some other part of the city. It's going to take a lot of time. Whereas if you go to a Zoomcar garage, there's a very high chance that, okay, there is a, if the car that you booked is not available, an alternate car could be arranged because there are a lot of cars in the garage, right? This is one reason. The second reason is if you go to a subscriber's home, Zap subscriber's home to pick up a car and there's a problem, maybe the stepney is flat, maybe something else wrong with the car, the support will take long, long time. There's no human being to talk to. You have to contact the customer care, and it is really, really complicated process to get things sorted, and it may take long time. But whereas if you go to a Zoomcar garage, Zoomcar's own locations, there will be some human beings and you can catch hold of them. Hey, fix this for me. Right? It's a lot easier that way to talk to a human being. Of course, Zoomcar is trying to automate. There are so many measures, but it's India and it is a lot simpler just to talk to a person and have them solve their problems than trying to work with a customer care, which is not really responsive or they take their own sweet time. Okay. So this is the third tip. Try to book from a Zoomcar location than a subscriber location. Now, there's no way to tell this during booking. On the website, there's no option. But only way you can figure it out is by knowing, okay, in your city, where all are the Zoomcar's own locations. So you have to figure it out and then give that location, and hopefully the car from that location gets assigned to your booking. So that's the only way. Okay. The last option, the last tip I would give is, if you are going on a long drive, right, keep some buffer. Don't begin your trip on a Saturday morning. Begin your trip, say, on a Friday afternoon or the evening. This is because most of their bookings come for the weekend. So Fridays evening, Saturday morning will be very busy time. Every car will be probably sold out. So if you reach on Saturday morning 10 o'clock and there is some problem with the car that was assigned to you, you are probably left there without a car. Whereas, if you're beginning your trip on a Friday afternoon, Friday evening, right? So you go to the location and there is something wrong with your car, they'll have more reaction time. So they can probably arrange alternate vehicle. They can, right? So you're reducing the risk a bit. So these are the tips I have when you're planning your booking, so that if something goes wrong, you have a buffer, you have some reaction time, and it's easier for them also to sort it out for you. And once you get your car, there are another set of precautions you need to take. That is obvious, all of you know it, right? Every single damage, every single scratch, you have to take photographs, videographs, and it's your own proof that it's an existing damage, because when you return the car, there will be somebody else and they will try to claim all this as new and try to extract money from you. So you need to have all the proof, take photos, videos, send it to their email address, right? So keep it, every document, every video evidence on your site that what are all the existing damages. Check if the spare wheel has air, check if there are wires dangling around, right? Check if the tire threads are worn out or if they are good enough, right? Check the fuel quantity, check if there's any leakage. So take whatever precaution you can to ensure that you document any existing damage, inconvenience before you start the trip. So that is very crucial, because a lot of people are being often forced to pay for damages that they did not do. They tried it even with me this year in Cochin. So existing damage, you said it is new, you damaged, I showed the photo, then you had to keep quiet. So this is your onus to ensure that you document all existing damages. Next is, of course, take good care of the car. I know you don't own it, you are only using it for a few days, but treat it well, drive carefully, don't drive where you're not supposed to or where the road is not meant for the kind of car you have rented. So please take good care of the car, then that should eliminate a lot of problems. Finally, always keep a plan B ready. Yes, despite all of our precautions, all the planning, there is a small probability that things will go horribly wrong. So what do you do? Right? If you know, or if you anticipate, okay, what will I do if this doesn't work out? Right? You will have less tension when it actually happens. So you can execute your plan B with more confidence than, you know, scrambling around in the last minute to what, thinking what to do, where to do. So for example, if you are driving a long distance, do you know where are all the nearby hospitals? Do you know where are all the nearby service centers for the car you are renting? Right? Do you know if there are, right, taxis available for you to rent and send your family members home? Right? Are you going too far interior where there is no telephone connection, and what is your plan B if something goes wrong? So you need to think all of this, have some plan in mind, have some actions or backup plans, then probably if things go wrong, you are more ready to tackle it than, you know, face a lot of inconveniences. So this is all what I had to say about booking on Zoomcar. Of course, some people say, I will never book on Zoomcar. But should you do that, I leave it to you. It's your discretion. If you have a better option, always feel free to go to other companies. But the truth is, nobody is perfect. It's a service industry and it's impossible to achieve 100% satisfaction rate. You take any company, there are bad experiences. You take OYO, there are people complaining about OYO. You take Make My Trip, a lot of people complaining about Make My Trip. You take Airtel, people are not happy with Airtel. So any company, there will be a fair percentage of customers who are disappointed, who had bad experiences. Some of them are pure bad luck. Some of them could be one-off cases, not applicable to everybody. And some of them could be can be fault on both sides, from the customer side, from the company side, some bad employees, some untrained employees. So things can happen. So a lot of times it's India, it's a mass market. For companies, it is a lot easier to acquire a dozen new customers by doing more marketing than try to pacify a disappointed customer, than try to keep everybody happy. So if there are a few people who are not happy, they will probably ignore and move on. So if you say, I will never book Zoomcar, I don't think they care. I don't think any company cares for that matter, because yes, it's a huge market, there are more customers to win, so they will be happy to acquire more customers and leave you aside. So yes, there is a bit of risk involved, a bit of luck is required, planning is required. So you can take, if you feel you have a better option, you can always go book with some other company. But I've had problems with Mylis, you have had problems with Rev. So every car company has their pros and cons. Sometimes a known devil is probably better than an unknown friend. So that's what I would say, because now I know how Zoomcar works, what are their tricks they play on me, or what are the things that can go wrong. So I'm well prepared to deal with Zoomcar. But if I go to a totally new company, then I have to begin from scratch. They may try a new trick that I could not anticipate. I may face a newer problem. So that's your call. So if you have a better option, you want to try your competitor, feel free. But if you're sometimes, like I said, a known devil could be better than an unknown friend. So if you want to continue with Zoomcar, if you're booking with Zoomcar, some of the tips that I told you, you might want to adopt and drive safe. Hope you guys found it useful. I have a lot of related blog posts as well related to self-drive topic. You might want to take a read. Descriptions are, the links are in the description. So thank you and have a nice day.